Hey, once again, everyone. In this video, we're going to take a look at how we can use the construction script to create customizable blueprints that a level designer can then modify inside the details panel right here without having to go inside your blueprint and make those modifications there. We'll also show you how you can use the construction script to create procedurally generated content really quickly inside the construction script as well. So let's go ahead and get started. I'm going to hop to the props folder of my starter content that I included with this project. And we're just going to use this static mesh here because we want the level designers to be able to make it a custom version of this particular mesh. So I'm going to right click on it. And under asset actions, going to go to create blueprint using this. It's going to ask for a name. I'm just going to leave the default name. That's fine. And we are now inside the blueprint editor here on the viewport tab, looking at that static mesh that we just turned into a blueprint. And I'm gonna hop over to the construction script now. And this script is a little bit different than our event graph. If you recall, the event graph executes any kind of functionality that we want to occur at runtime while our game is playing. The construction script fires anytime any properties of this blueprint are changed inside the editor. So it's a very handy script, especially for customization purposes. So let's go ahead and see how we can do this. I'm gonna click on our static mesh again inside the components window really quickly. All of these properties that you see for that static mesh, such as the materials, for example, or whether you're simulating physics, these can all be defined inside the construction script here as variables that can then be exposed to your level designers. So let's see how we can do that. Say we wanted to change the materials of this particular mesh. We can do that by holding control and dragging in our static mesh here. We can then drag off of it and say set material. And you can see we now have the ability to specify an index and a default material to use. And let's go ahead and control C and control V just so we have two of them. And let's connect them all up like so. And for this element, let's go ahead and make this element 1 because we have element 0 and element 1 for this particular static mesh. And let's make sure that our target is connected. And the next thing we need to do is promote our materials to variables. Now we could specify, you know, what the materials are here, but we want to make these variables. So let's go ahead and drag off this material here and promote to variable. Just gonna move that down so it's not hiding up there. And I'm gonna do the same thing for this one, promote to variable and move it down. Now inside the details panel, we can give them a name. Let's just call this index 0 and make sure that it is editable. And when you click this checkbox here in the details panel to make it editable, you also see it inside the My Blueprint window with this little eye icon. This will show you that it is a publicly editable variable. So we're going to do the same thing for the other variable there. So go ahead and call this index 1 and make sure that it is editable. And now we can compile and save. And once we compile, you'll see that we have the option of setting the default values for these. So let's go ahead and set some default values for our level designers. For example, we want it to be white on the outside, and the inside we want to be gold. Let's compile. If we go to the viewport, you can kind of see that now. There's our default static mesh there. Now if we hop back to the level and find that blueprint, which I saved mine here, and we drag it into our level, there's our default setting right there. Now our level designer can look inside the details panel over here and change those settings if they would like. So they could also hold Alt, for example, and drag out a copy and say that this particular instance of this mesh is brick and the inner is, I don't know, let's try something, steel. There you go. So there you go. You can now have a customizable blueprint here that your level designers can modify right there on the fly inside the details panel without having to go into the blueprint itself and make those changes. And this can be done for anything. I mean, if you open up, let's actually go back to it. If you had a light, for example, let's just add another component here. Let's add a spotlight for fun because it looks like one of those spotlight things that you see movie premieres, right? Let's go ahead and just move it up and let's press E to rotate it and move it back down like so, something like this. That looks like a spotlight. You could also add this to your construction script as well. So now that we've added that component, we could hold control and drag it in. And we could say set intensity, for example. And we could say set color. And let's see, I think those two are good. You get the idea. We could drag off of these now, promote those to variables. So this is the intensity or brightness of the light. Let's make that a variable as well. I'm just going to hit F2 here and just say brightness. Brightness, that's about right. And for color, drag off this, promote that to variable. Let's call this one color. Promote that to an editable variable. And let's compile and save. So it gives us some defaults to play with. So the default value is not 0. It is, say, 10,000. So, and the color, let's just give it a nice green color, for example. Let's move that down. So if we compile and we go back to our level now, we now have our static mesh that also has a light component. Let's hold Alt and just drag out a copy. Point it towards the wall here so you can see it. So you get the idea. Now it has a green light. I can drag out a copy of that inside the details panel, change the material to something else if I'd like. Like this one has that, and the inside is this material for some reason. And this light color is red. And there you go. That is a customizable blueprint right there. The other thing that we want to show you really quickly here is how to create some procedural content. There's several different ways that you could do this. So we're just going to show you a quick example using the construction script here. I'm actually going to right-click in the content browser here and create an empty blueprint class here. Going to name it an actor. And we want to create some random bushes in our level, for example. So I'm going to say, call this the bush BP. Going to open that up. And you see we have no components in here right now. It's just empty blueprint here. I'm going to hop directly to the construction script here. And what we need to define is how many bushes we want randomly spawned. So for that, that is going to be a variable. I'm going to click the variable button here and just say how many bushes. And we don't want it to be a Boolean. We want it to be an integer. And it is going to be publicly editable. And by default, we'll say 5 bushes. So inside the construction script here, going to search for a for loop. For loop. And connect that to my construction script here, like so. And the first index, we're going to set that to 1. And the last index, which is the max, we're just going to drag this and place it right on top. Because this is going to be something that our level designers can define. So we'll at least place 1, and the max that we'll place is whatever our level designers decide. So with that off the loop body here, I'm going to add static mesh component. And once we do so, you see inside the details panel with this node selected, we could specify the mesh that we want to spawn. So if you recall, we have nothing in here yet. But once we define a static mesh to spawn, such as a bush, if we go back to the viewport and compile, there is our bush that is spawned via the construction script here. So it's asking for a transform. We're actually going to say random. Random unit vector is what we want there. And this is going to place our bush in a random XYZ coordinate. We do want to make one modification to it. We want to multiply this, multiply it by a float to give us a range. And for the sake of fun, we're also going to promote this to a variable that our level designers can specify. So I'm going to drag off this and promote to variable. And we'll just call this the modifier. Going to compile really quickly and enter a value for this, such as 100. And for our purposes, we don't want the Z. In this particular example, we only want the X and Y coordinates. So what I'm going to do is drag off of this and break the vector. So it gives me the X, and X, Y, and Z coordinates. Going to right click and say make vector now. Not vectory, but a vector. And going to connect the X and Y, like so. And leave the Z alone because we don't want height. We want to keep that on the level plane there. And once I connect my return value to my relative transform, a conversion node will be created for me. And just a quick double check, I did specify our modifier. So I'm going to hit compile. And if I look in my viewport now, you can see that we got multiple bushes spawned in our viewport. And if we drag them in our level, let's drag in this blueprint into our level here. You can see as we move our bush now, it's being updated with a random amount that we specify. Did we make that? Let's hop back to our bush really quickly. We didn't make this public editable. There we go. So let's make sure that both of those are publicly editable for our designer friends. And now inside the details panel, we have both of those options. We could say, oh, let's space them out to 1,000. And let's add 60 bushes, for example. Now you could see how we could use this to our advantage when we are placing things in our level to give us a random appearance. These are all procedurally generated via our construction script. So there you have it. You have learned how to create some procedural content in its minimalist form, as well as exposing variables to allow you to have custom blueprints as well. We hope you guys enjoyed this video, and we will see you next time.